you know, a couple of weeks ago on the Milton Berle Show, our next guest, Elvis Presley, received a great deal of attention, which some people seem to interpret one way and some viewers interpret it another. Naturally, it's our intention to do nothing but a good show. Somebody's barking back there. We want to do a show the whole family can watch and enjoy, and we always do. And tonight we are presenting Elvis Presley in his, what you might call his first comeback. And at this time, it gives me extreme pleasure to introduce the new Elvis Presley. Here he is. Well, Elvis, you're certainly being a real good sport about the whole thing, and now I have a little surprise for you. Gene, can I have it? With the great vocal group, the George Mayers, in the background. Elvis, your new record hit, I predict it's going to be one because I've heard you rehearse it. You're going to record it tomorrow, called Hound Dog. I got you a very cute little hound dog right here. And away you go. Who's that?
Elvis will often refer to this night as the most ridiculous performance of my entire career.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. Well, I said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, you ain't never caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't never caught a rabbit. You ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a...
The very next morning, Elvis, Scotty, Bill, and DJ team up with the Jordanaires in the RCA recording studios and cut Hound Dog.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time.
Listening to playbacks, Elvis decides he wants to try another take. Supposedly, the session is run by RCA A&R man Steve Scholes. But it's clearly the 21-year-old Elvis who's in charge.
Huh?
Elvis may have been willing to sing to a dog on TV, but when it comes to his own music, nobody is more serious.
That was a good opening.
Elvis learned production during his son days with Sam Phillips. But his instincts tell him to change his style. Instead of the echo and the reverb of rockabilly, he wants something bigger, more explosive. Steve Scholes wants Elvis to quit after 18 takes. Even the band thinks he's got the song right. But Elvis insists on doing 30 takes of the song before he's really satisfied. After listening to the playbacks, he chooses number 28. As hard as he works on Hound Dog, the next song is a breeze. Flipping through a stack of demos, Elvis selects a song from New York songwriter Otis Blackwell called Don't Be Cruel. He quickly works out the arrangement on piano with the band and cuts the song in 8 takes.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Hound Dog and Don't Be Cruel become Elvis's 3rd and 4th gold records of the year.
You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please tell the phone. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said, please don't forget my past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't be cruel.
Elvis records still another song, the ballad, Any Way You Want Me. He takes three quick acetate pressings of the songs with him and leaves the studio.
I don't want no other love, baby, it's just you I'm thinking of.
He's going home to Memphis.
I've been traveling over miles, even through
the trip to Memphis is a 28-hour train ride. And it gives Elvis a chance to relax, catch up on some sleep, and listen to the acetates from his recording session. Colonel Parker is now orchestrating Elvis's career like a million-dollar sideshow. He is about to sign a deal to merchandise 72 different Elvis Presley products with Hank Saperstein, who sells toys for Wyatt Earp, the Lone Ranger, and Ding Dong School. In no time at all, Elvis's face is on everything from clothing to bubblegum cards.
Well, nothing that could hold me.
In 6 months, these Presley Mania products earned $22 million.
When it was dark at night, he would shine as bright as light. When I was trying to get to you.
At a stop in a rural suburb of Memphis that isn't much more than a grass field, the colonel lets his boy go with instructions to say hello to his mother Gladys. Elvis gets off the train alone, carries only his record. The best part of Elvis's success is what he can do now for his parents. The devoted son buys them a brand new home in a Memphis suburb on Audubon Drive. New pink and white Cadillacs stand in the driveway. The ranch-style house is the first home the Presleys have ever owned.
When I do get some time off, I always go home and see my folks, and I ride a motorcycle and do different things.
Fans are already out front waiting under the carport. For now, Elvis can meet and talk with his fans openly. But within a year, the Presleys will need more privacy, and Elvis will move to Graceland. Family and friends are all on hand to greet the returning hero. Elvis's father, Vernon, his cousin, Junior Smith, Grandma, Minnie Mae Presley, who Elvis calls the Dodger. Elvis takes a dip in the family's brand new swimming pool. With his hair still wet, Elvis proudly plays the acetate of Any Way You Want Me for his high school sweetheart, Barbara Hearn.
I'll be as strong as a mountain, or weak as a willow tree.
Right now, Elvis likes being with local Memphis girls he knew before he became a star. Within the year, Elvis will be dating Las Vegas showgirls and Hollywood starlets like Natalie Wood. More than anything, the visit home means time to spend catching up with his mother.
I suppose since I was an only child, that we might have been a little closer, and mother was always right with me all my life. A friend, a companion, someone to talk to. I could wake her up any hour of the night, and if I was worried or troubled about something, she'd get up and try to help me.
And now that he's home from the road, she makes sure that he has plenty of clean underwear. Before long, it's time to get ready for the evening's concert. It's a July 4th benefit at Russ Wood Stadium in Memphis. ...14,000 people show up to see their hometown boy. When he takes the stage at 10:30 that night, a promise is delivered to the family and friends who watched his rise from the start. Elvis tells them, "Those people in New York are not going to change me none. I'm going to show you what the real Elvis Presley is like tonight."
Some Lord with the pots and pan. I believe to my soul you're the devil in nylon hole. I believe to my soul you're the devil in nylon hole. Cause what I work the faster my money go. Well, I said shake, rattle and roll. 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 The way you want to ride to save your doggone soul.
No task is too small for the Colonel when it comes to promoting his boy. Outside the stadium, the Colonel sells 8x10 glossies of Elvis, suitable for framing, at 10 cents a pop. The first 2 weeks of August, Elvis begins a series of one-nighters in Florida.
Ready, set, go, man, go. I got a gal that I love so. Ready to rock and roll. Down to the corner, pick up my sweetie pie. Give my rock and roll, baby, she's high for love, my high.
A Jacksonville juvenile court judge issues a restraining order to stop him from making offensive gyrations on stage.
A shovel to the left, a shovel to the right, gonna rock and roll to the other
side. To satisfy the court, Elvis moves only his little finger, and the kids still go wild. Filming starts on the Reno Brothers August 23rd. Elvis shows up on the set the first day with the entire script memorized, his lines and everybody else's.
There's nobody who helps you out. They have a director and a producer. As far as the acting and all, you're on your own. I might accomplish something at it through the years.
Kathy? What you doing? Something wrong?
No, Clint, nothing.
Kathy, you're crying. What are you crying about?
I don't know, Clint. I had a bad dream, I guess. The war and everything.
Oh, don't cry. We're all safe again. There's nothing to worry about anymore.
I hope not.
He's surprised to find that Paramount has slipped 4 songs into the movie. Hal Wallace decides he doesn't want a bunch of hillbillies out of Nashville playing on his soundtrack and tells Elvis he can't use Scotty, Bill, and DJ to record the songs. Instead, Elvis must sing with the Ken Darby Trio. The Reno Brothers now becomes Love Me Tender. And so begins Elvis's career in Hollywood.
Love me tender, love me true. All my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me long, take me to your heart. For it's there that I belong, and we'll never part.
On September 9, Elvis makes his first of three appearances on the Ed Sullivan Show. Sullivan vowed never to have Elvis the Pelvis on his show, but the sheer power of Elvis's popularity forces him to change his mind.
Ready, set, go, man, go. I got a gal that I love so. Rock and roll, baby, she's out for it. Ready, 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 ready to rock and roll. Not a hot dog chef, not a dungaree dog. I'm headed to the gym, to the sock hop ball. The gym and the cats are going wild. The music really sent my day to the
My friends would like to introduce you to a brand new song, Love Me Tender.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go.
The sweetness of the ballad and the honest warmth of the delivery blunt the edge of public wrath. As the country boy shows his other side, more are converted. 54 million people watch the show. One out of every three Americans.
Love me true.
The very next day, RCA gets 1 million advance orders for Love Me Tender. Now Elvis gets his fifth gold record of the year.
I love you, and I always will.
Elvis returns to his birthplace in Tupelo, Mississippi on September 26 as the star attraction at the state fair. He receives a hero's welcome, and the mayor gives him the key to the city.
I hope you will take this key and use it the best way you see fit.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, very much.
Restless by river.
His triumphant return is a classic American success story. Elvis was born and bred in a tiny shotgun house on the edge of Tupelo. A 10-year-old Elvis won second prize at this same state fair for singing Old Shep, a song about a boy and his dog. Now he performs for 22,000 people and donates his $10,000 fee to charity. Today he wears a velvet shirt made for him by his mom. Next year, he'll return for another benefit, dressed in his famous gold lamé suit, designed in Hollywood. On October 24th, Variety publishes a front-page banner headline, Elvis, a millionaire in 1 year. Love Me Tender is released on November 16th, premiering in New York City. 3,000 teenagers scream as a 40-foot-high statue of Elvis is unveiled. Elvis's transformation into a movie star is complete, even if some fans are disappointed that the film contains no rock and roll music.
Love me tender.
Critics pan the film, but it makes back its $1 million production cost within days. At the end of 1956, the two top-grossing films in the nation are Giant, starring James Dean, and Love Me Tender, starring Elvis Presley. Elvis appeared for the last time on The Ed Sullivan Show, January 6, 1957. Almost 1 year to the day since a 21-year-old Elvis Presley first entered the RCA studio to cut Heartbreak Hotel. By now, his hair is dyed jet black because he believes it'll photograph better for the movies. And he thinks it makes him look a little like Tony Curtis.
You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please a telephone.
Sullivan makes one last desperate attempt to censor Elvis by photographing him only from the waist up. Final song on the show, Elvis performs the gospel classic, Peace in the Valley.
Well, I'm tired and so weary, but I must go alone till the Lord comes and calls me away. And the lamb is alive, and the night, night is as black as the sea. Oh, yes, there will be peace in the valley for me someday. There will be peace in the valley. Oh, 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 me, oh Lord, I pray. There'll be no sadness, no sorrow,
oh, my Lord,
no
trouble
I see.
There will be peace in the valley for me.
It's the end of an era. Elvis will make only three more TV appearances in his lifetime.
Treat me like a fool, treat me mean and cruel, but love me.
After 1956, his stardom becomes so unprecedented that it turns his world upside down. In 1957, his concerts are so big and unmanageable that Elvis stops touring. The original band of Scotty, Bill, and DJ break up. Elvis moves to the privacy of Graceland with his family, and right at the very peak of his success, his beloved mother passes away. He goes on to make a total of 33 films, and becomes the highest paid star in Hollywood. He sells a billion records worldwide. Rarely has a single man so greatly affected the world through his music. But after 1956, we'd never be able to get that close to him again.
I want your heart.
heart beating close to mine.
So close to mine.
Wherever you ever go, darling, I'll be oh so lonely, begging on my knees. Love me, oh yeah.
Just my baby left me, never said a word. Was it something I done, something that she heard? My baby left me. My baby left me. My baby even left me. Never said a word. Lord, I stand at my window, wring my hands and cry. I hate to lose that woman, hate to say goodbye. You know she left me. Yes, she left me.